Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Let's hop right into the flip through for September. I ended up really liking this colorful 90s vibe, but I did not keep up with tracking things, as you can see. I did manage to go camping though and go to Seattle for a day because my best friend was visiting with her boyfriend, so I met him for the first time. And then just random stuff I threw into the days. But let's get started with October. If you know me at all, you know that October is my favorite month of the year. Yes, I'm sure lots of people are saying that, but my birthday is in October, so it's always been my favorite month. And I just have a spooky little soul, so obviously I love Halloween. So my plan for this month was kind of to do some like witchy things, little spooky things. I didn't want to go full kind of cartoony Halloween. That's not really, wasn't really my vibe, but I don't know. I've been really liking Ouija board sort of things. I have like Ouija socks, and I'm working on a planchette painting as well, so I was like, why not? Let's go for this. So that's what I'm doing here on this opening page is a planchette and then October written on it in a really cool font that I found on Pinterest, as I usually find them there. So that's what I'm doing there. You'll find through this thing, I really wanted to do a minimalistic color scheme with it. I've done a lot of really colorful ones, and I just wanted to keep this one kind of cool and spooky, mostly like black and white and gray, a little bit of purple. But once I finished and I was done filming, I really wasn't happy with it. It felt really unfinished to me, and it might be because the pages of this particular journal, which is linked below, and I don't know how to pronounce it, so I'm not gonna try. They're not exactly white. They're more of an off-white color. And they're a little bit on the thinner side too. So they just, it didn't look right. So I actually played around with it a little bit after I was finished filming, and I took some pictures, and I'm gonna throw them in here as long as I figure out how to do that. Because by the way, this is the first time I am editing my own YouTube video, so I was pretty nervous but pretty excited about it. So the next page here, I tried to make the background behind the calendar kind of look like a wooden thing because I wanted it to kind of look like a Ouija board, but obviously without everything on it because that wouldn't work with a calendar. It'd be way too busy. It's already very busy. So I tried to figure out a wood grain, and it was a lot of work, but it ended up looking pretty cool. But it did take a very long time. I did bring the font from the beginning page over to here. Not loving how it came out. I tried to fix it a little bit. You'll see when I pop the picture up for you. But I don't know, still not super happy with it. But my cauldron is pretty cute. And I'm throwing also a lot of stars and moons in here because I just love stars and moons. It's the first thing I doodle when I'm doodling. And I don't know, I just vibe with them a lot. I have like stars and moon jewelry. And yeah, that's me. While I did the wood grain, I also switched around different sizes of the pens. So I did like a really small one, like a 0.1 or something. I did a 3, I did a 5, and then I did the Fudanesque brush to make a few really thick lines at the end. Whew, see, I told you that took a long time, and I skipped around for you guys. I wanted to spare you that. So now I'm doing my stars and moons on the side here, kind of like coming out of the cauldron like it's magic. And then you'll see the purple that I use are these new Kirarich Zebra glitter highlighters. I saw someone use them on Instagram and I had to find them. So I ended up finding them at a local shop here called Collage. I was very excited, especially because I still had a gift card to that store. So I didn't even have to pay for them, but they're very pretty and glittery. I don't know how much it's going to show up here for you, but when you see the pictures on Instagram and stuff, you'll see more glitter in them. And actually, if you go over there, I did a little test page of them, and you can see the glitter on there as well. They came in a 5-pack, and there's purple, pink, yellow, blue, and green. And I ended up going back in and adding a little bit of color with the yellow and the green. But then the yellow was like a really highlighter yellow, and so I ended up going over it with a yellow Tombow. But I'll show you that when I pop it onto the screen. So yeah, see how it's so busy with the wood grain and then the lettering as well. And then I did a light gray to kind of highlight the words, or the days of the week rather, but it's really busy, especially in the small part at the top. But we'll go back and fix it. So the next page is my usual faves and memories pages. You know that I love these pages. I love filling up with pictures and music and stuff. A lot of music lately, more so than TV and movies, which is kind of good, right? Should probably add some books in there, but either way. But I did it a little differently, and I kind of made the title portion look like tarot cards of the sun and moon, but instead of writing sun or moon, I just wrote faves and memories. And then I added a couple little crystal balls, mainly just so I could add some more purple in, because purple is my favorite color, and these markers are real pretty. But look at me not even being able to trace my own lines properly. I'm a mess. I loved this theme that I drew out so much, and then as I was coloring it, I feel like I made it worse. But I hope you guys like it at least. I mean, that's part of why I do this though, is I don't want everybody to like be overwhelmed by all these wonderful artists doing it and being like, I can't do this, so it's not gonna be fun for me. But I'm not a great artist, but I still have so much fun bullet journaling. This is my habit trackers page, and it is one of my favorites because I love the doodle that I drew at the bottom, and I love the way that the font came out for the word habit. So I'm very happy with this page. It's my favorite page in the whole spread. So the things I'm tracking are skincare. I have an Apple Watch, so I make sure I hit my move goals every day. What day of the week I'm doing the cat box, just so I don't let it go too long because I don't remember what day that I did it. I have like a little laser hair removal thing, and you're supposed to do it once a week for like 8 weeks. I've been very lax on it, but I need to get back into it, and I want to track what days I'm doing that as well. And then my last one is social media posts. So just marking off, making sure that I post at least on one of my social medias once a day, hopefully. And then my little doodle is a moon with some crystals and some little sparkly things and a couple little leaves. The next page is something that I did last year, because actually this is my first full year doing bullet journaling. I started October of last year, so this makes 1 year for me. And I'm gonna write spooky movies in one section of that, and then like spoopy with a P movies in the other portion, which are like the cute ones like Hocus Pocus and Nightmare Before Christmas. The other one's gonna be actual horror movies that I watch, because I will spend all month watching these movies. Not that I don't watch them the rest of the year, but just really like to get myself in the vibe. This page with the cauldron, not 100% sure what I'm doing with it yet. I just had an extra page, so I drew a cauldron, and I was thinking of tracking like jobs I'm applying for, or something like that. But keep up with me on Instagram and I'm sure I'll let you know what I do with it. Now we're getting into the weekly layout. I had to figure out something to do with it because it starts on a Thursday and it was just weird. And I'm also trying to put a lot on one page because we're getting towards the end of the year, which means I'm getting towards the end of the book. And I'm sure as heck not starting a new book for like 1 or 2 months. So I'm just like trying to use the pages sparingly. So I did 6 boxes on this first page, did the month with the cute font, did some more crystals because they're so cute and I figured out how to draw them, and then a little calendar at the bottom with some little stars on it. Use that glittery highlighter again. Now here's where I really mess up. I really should have folded the page first, but I didn't. And when I folded it over, it hit the glue too soon, and now it's all wrinkly. I cut a lot of me fighting with it out for you guys, but I could not get it back unstuck. But anyway, that's what I did for that. So now I went back to my future log, and I'm bringing over the stuff that's happening for the month, like my best friend's birthday on the 1st, my birthday's on the 4th, The Walking Dead season finale is finally airing, also on my birthday, and then of course Halloween, and then I'll fill in things as it goes. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, maybe hit the bell for notifications, and follow me over on Instagram. It's CurvyKCreations. And then you can also follow me on Twitter if you like. It's KelBellTweets. All right, have a super spooky season. I can't wait to see you guys in November. Bye!